We're back! Yes, none the worse for Christmas and New Year's.
And has it been New Year's yet? What day is it?
Actually, no, by the time I put this up.
Just
but anyway.
The pulsating pectorals.
Look what we're doing! We're playing an adventure game and actually going to finish it. It's a let's play, not a drown out.
And fiddle around and take our good goddamn time.
So we won't get distracted by news stories and complain about SJWs this time, hopefully.
Well,
I'm
not even
sure
news.
SJWs will have complaints for this. Anyway, this is the Leisure Suit Larry tradition where it asks you questions that it thinks only adults would know the answers to.
Cat Stevens is. But I'm a songwriter who got religion.
I'm deliberately getting these wrong because I don't want to have to not work save this video.
Trilateral Commission would be a good name for a Eurofunk synth band.
Well, I guess I thought the same thing. But it turns out it hardly matters with this game.
Of course it.
Yes. Actually, I've done the game in two parts. The first part will be in zero dirtiness level.
Yeah.
And the second part will be on maximum dirtiness for reasons that will become clear.
I honestly don't think I've ever played one of the Leisure Suit Larry games with minimum dirtiness.
Yeah, it sort of seems like defeating the point in many ways.
Yeah,
isn't it?
It's like playing Mortal Kombat with the blood off. It's like, I know it's an option, but
I mean, you do still have sex with women, and there's still a lot of adult themes. It's just they're sort of censored in the most ridiculous ways.
Evil Doctor No Nookie.
Yeah. Which was a reference to Leisure Suit Larry 2, of course. I think Leisure Suit Larry 3 and Leisure Suit Larry 2 were part of this whole sort of weird phase for this series, where it was trying to recapture the tone of the first Leisure Suit Larry game, which was, to my mind, a very cynical game. And then it just sort of banded around for a while. Leisure Suit Larry 2 was this very weird linear plot about defeating Russian agents and stuff that sort of went all over the place.
Huh.
And so they're trying to get back to the original, thing by making this game about having sex with women and generally being a big old sleazeball. But then it gets some weird tones and, I don't think it's as cynical as the first Legends of Larry game, which, lest we forget, is set in like a XP of Las Vegas and where you get taken in by a gold digger and steals all your money.
Mm-hmm. And you lose your virginity to a prostitute?
Yes, and you lose your virginity to a prostitute. Yeah, if this had been on super adult mode, she would have closed those blinds a very small amount.
Mm.
And you would have actually seen her titties. And that's about the most adult thing this game gets.
That was impressive back before the internet.
I had
Leisure Suit Larry 5. That was probably one of my earlier ones, and I played a lot of Leisure Suit Larry 5. So.
Well, as should be well known, this is the game that came between Leisure Suit Larry 2 and Leisure Suit Larry 5, because there was no Leisure Suit Larry 4.
In a bizarrely sort of modern ironic kind of move.
There's a couple of reasons why. The story I tend to believe is that Al Lowe was quoted as saying he'd never make a Leisure Suit Larry 4 and he wanted to remain honest.
I believe that.
So what's happening here is that at the end of Leisure Suit Larry 2, we saved this desert island that we're on and we were married the chieftain's daughter. Like I said, it's a very weird plot. And now it's some years later, we've grown fat and complacent, and our wife is divorcing us. And oh my goodness, lesbians, edgy! It's the 80s.
So it was like years before Ellen came out. This is amazing.
And I guess the thing.
It's groundbreaking.
I guess the thing about this game is that it seems kind of cruel, but without making out Leisure Suit Larry as like deserving of the cruelty as he was in Leisure Suit Larry 1.
Yeah, because there's like a bumbling, adorable jokiness to the later ones.
Yeah.
Where he's an idiot, but he's a well-meaning idiot. And, the bad things that befall him are usually just comical.
Hmm.
Doesn't look like Larry really either.
Well, not at the moment, no. But this was part of this whole Sierra period that I think also included Space Quest 3. Because like Space Quest 3, we will have no idea what the fuck we're supposed to be doing. Except some vague, nebulous idea we're going to seduce lots of chicks.
Yeah. I fucking hate that. No goals in point-and-click adventure games.
Yes, we'll be given very little direction.
Now we're just going to Bill and Ted our way the fuck out of there.
And now he's Leisure Suit Larry again. but wearing what doesn't really look much like a leisure suit. Because, to my mind, a leisure suit should have, like,
the flares,
an open top button and a big aeroplane collar.
And the gold chain.
And the gold chain. But it looks like he's just wearing a white suit with a black shirt.
Mm.
It's not the same.
See, it's that kind of quality writing that was lost in the console, generations.
Hmm.
You needed PCs for those kind of jokes.
Well, that was me typing get wood there. Mm. I could have just typed get stick or get bit of twig. We couldn't have done this while we were wearing the Hawaiian outfit. Yes.
Why?
I suspect because the game didn't create animations for you doing certain things wearing anything other than your white suit.
Yeah.
So there's a couple of occasions where we're wearing different outfits and the game will just refuse to do certain things with no real explanation.
You haven't triggered that event.
So now we have a credit card.
Rock and roll, and that is worth 26 points.
Yes, and this will fund our first endeavor to seduce women.
So that was really just, that's the most goal we just got there, was I'm on an island and I'm single.
Yeah.
Okie dokie.
And we're going to seduce women, as I said. I say seduce. I mean, it's sort of the pattern for the first part of this game that Larry basically pays women for sex several times over.
With cash or some sort of barter system?
With mixtures of the two, yes. Now we're going to the place where we work, yes.
I couldn't take anyone called Chairman Kenneth seriously.
Well, this is the chieftain from the second game, whose daughter we married, and who is, I think, a spoof on Ken Williams, the director of Sierra, because he's a fat dude with a moustache. You remember when we did Space Quest 3? This is the guy who showed up at the very end of the game and hired those two guys.
Before everything got meta as fuck.
Yes. So now Larry's getting more cruelty subjected to him.
What just happened? Did you slip over?
Yeah. No. Well, they invited him to sit down and then said, not on the couch. So he just sat on the floor. Yeah, this game has like a...
It's not an auto-save, it's just an auto...
rather unique option that invites you to save every 5 minutes. Which, you know, makes sense for Sierra game.
Yeah.
Although it didn't stop me completely screwing the pooch as I played through this game.
So you saved yourself into dead ends?
Well, we'll get to that.
Dead ends. I don't mind dead ends in point-and-click adventure games if they kind of have a way of telegraphing that they're there. I think that was probably one of the most irritating things of playing... I Have No Mouth and I Must Scream Again, is that game has got fucking shitloads of dead ends built in, and they're really complex dead ends. Like, you can get to them via, like, cutscenes and shit, so you think you're going fine, and then you're bumbling around this little fucking cul-de-sac of unsolvable problems doing nothing.
So now we've been fired. Fired for being divorced by our wife.
This is the Ghostbusters 2 start, where it's like we reset everything to the existing, you know...
Yeah, it's like the Metroid style, where you lose all your powers.
You're a badass. Missiles are gone.
There you go. Whoops. Yep. Now, you might notice this, viewer, but when we were in the office earlier, Chairman Kenneth used the phrase golly gee. And that's because the game has a sort of custom expletive option, which repeatedly shows up in dialogue. I'm replacing it with my personal favourite one there.
That's a feature that should be in more modern games. That's great. Fucking, the only thing that was close to that was one of the Tony Hawk games on, I think, the DS. You could record your own little voice thing for when you did, like, special tricks. That was fun.
Now, I want to know the difference between this and the raunchiest setting.
Yes.
She doesn't put her top back on before she stands up. Well, as you can see, she covers up her nips anyway.
More sweet underboob. I like underboob. Like, the kind of hint of boob. Then I'm excited to see nipple. You know, if the nipple's just there, it's kind of like, anticipation. That shit's important.
Well, you can anticipate away, because we're never actually going to see this lady's titties. Even on the raunchiest setting, we wouldn't.
God damn it!
But now she kind of looks like Zsa Zsa Gabor. Now
we're looking so lonely.
But yes, this will be our first conquest.
Leisure Suit Larry. Lie to get sex.
Well, we're not actually going to lie. We're going to ascertain from one line of dialogue that she likes shopping. And then we're just going to give her our credit card.
Are you fucking for real?
Yes, this is how seduction works. I hope you're listening, like men of the internet.
I know. Like, okay. Stop what you're doing, pickup artists. Everyone come here. There you go. That was like, what, 50 points? Holy crap, that was it. You just literally just here, have a credit card.
Now, in the raunchy mode, they'd be gyrating and animating and stuff.
Ooh.
And really, I don't see the point. I mean, in both modes, we're always having sex.
Yeah.
It's just, there isn't an animation now.
I find, like, you know, the sort of, like, how people decide what to censor when they're censoring things is always really interesting to me. Like,
well, I think if you're gonna
make the blood green and it's okay, let's have them not move and then suddenly they're not fucking, even though they're clearly, that's what's happening.
Well, if you're gonna have, like, a raunchy game, and you want to have, like, a kiddie mode.
Yeah,
I think the best way I've seen that done was in a text adventure called the Spellcasting series, which was a sort of Harry Potter meets Porky's sort of thing, where you're a nerdy wizard in a wizard school. And
that is a series of movies I didn't know I needed to see until now.
And you seduce hot, wizardy chicks and cheerleaders and stuff. But if you were playing, like, the non-raunchy mode of that game, it would, instead of, like, having sex with women, you would, like, do the dishes with them or play chess with them.
That's a text adventure, though, right?
Yeah. So it was, you know, it would have been easier to implement.
Yeah.
But, you know, you could have just... I remember I once hacked into the first Legacy Larry game, and I changed all the sex to just be innocent things. Like, instead of having sex with a prostitute, I replaced the sensor bar with the two of you playing D&D on the bed.
That is a fun and safe alternative for you teens.
Because I was irreverent about a lot of things. Yeah, now we're going to do a crabs joke.
I would never want to fuck on the beach. The last thing I could fuck, like, oh, you know what would be fun? Sand.
Well, yes, it's very bad for infections. Or should I say very good for infections, having sex on the beach. Yeah, I just noticed she's not wearing her top now.
My god, I've thought about boobs. Now my 13-year-old self is going to go on a murder rampage.
Yes, and now we're doing the sex comedy thing where the sex is constantly interrupted. The confessions of a window cleaner thing. Where you never get to finish what you're doing because it turns into a hilarious slapstick joke.
Like having a full live crab down your pants. I butchered my hands eating a crab yesterday. Those things are jerks. I don't know why we bother eating them.
So we got a knife from all that.
Doki doki.
Because she bought a knife from that peddler. And now we sharpen it on the steps. Nothing else made of stone will do. Only these steps. At least I don't think so.
See, and this isn't... Like, in later Sierra games, and particularly, like, the LucasArts ones, where you could, like, scan around with the mouse.
The LucasArts Sierra games?
No, I mean, in the Sierra games and... like later LucasArts ones, you can scan around with the mouse and the mouse would tell you that there's things there. So you could figure out, like, okay, the steps are an object, so I could maybe interact with them.
You couldn't do that so easily in the Sierra point-and-click games, because as I recall, you could point-and-click on everything.
The Sea...
And then you just be like, you just look at the background.
Space Quest 6 had it, didn't it?
No. You just
maybe
looked,
I'm blurring that in with the...
Whatever you clicked on would produce dialogue. It would often just be the dialogue for the whole room there.
Can you do that in this, where you look and it tells you, like, here are the things you can...
Well, you can look, but some things aren't that obvious.
So that's kind of dickish.
If we're making a grass skirt, because we're going to disguise ourselves as the native peddler we saw sell something to that girl.
Okay.
And yes, as we established earlier, there's absolutely no direction that would lead you this way. We're doing all this for 20 bucks. I'll give that away now. We're going to get 20 bucks, and then we're going to use that to make our way to the next lady to seduce.
Do you suppose people actually legitimately solved these, or did they buy, like, the guides?
Well, that was the thing, wasn't it? I mean, in this game, every time you die, one of the options on the, like, the death window is order hint book. And it sounds like a joke, but it did actually take you to a phone number you could call to get to order a hint book. Which is a little bit blatant, I suppose.
I cannot imagine someone being able to sort of stumble their way through. I mean, I know probably, you know, 1,000 monkeys at 1,000 typewriters. Someone's managed it.
But why would you need to when there's hint books?
I figured that's what would happen. Someone would get the hint book and then...
And then tell all their friends.
And then in the really early days of the internet, it'd pop up.
So we're wearing a different costume, and that means we can't do anything but the one thing we do with this costume.
Oh, it's not tonight.
Yes, I think.
Yeah, non-tonight. Yeah.
Non...
Has a dick on it.
Well, actually, since we're playing on the completely non-raunchy mode, it will have no dick at all. Well, it would in, it would in raunchy mode, yes.
That is a photo. That's like, that's a dick pic just without the dick. That's
yeah, very weird framing.
Yeah.
See, that would have been an innuendo if it had a dick, but it isn't now.
Yeah. Joke's just ruined. It's completely silly.
Yes.
Okay, so we just got $20 by selling the woman we were just sort of half doing a...
Yes. I mean, we could have just taken $20 while we were doing her, but we didn't have the presence of mind.
Didn't know we should steal from her yet.
Well, we got one inventory item from shagging her. What more did we want?
Oh, in the inventory item shuffle. These old graphics just don't do his face right, you know?
Well, you hardly could you?
I know, but it's just...
I know what you mean. I mean, in the first Legacy Larry game, you got an impression...
Yeah, like...
Of what his face was like, just because of the dimensions.
Now he's like...
He was more cartoony.
If you were to show me that, I wouldn't go, oh, Legacy Larry.
I'm not sure how necessary what we're doing now is. I mean, you get points for it.
It's like going to the toilet in Legacy Larry, is it 6? Yeah, shape up a ship out and wiping your butt.
Yeah.
Like, that's points. Don't need to do it ever. And if you forget to wipe your butt, I think the game ends.
Well, that was the additional challenge. It was like 100% mode.
Yeah, I suppose.
Gotta find the hidden stuff. Yes, thank you, autosave.
Asperger.
It'll do that at some quite inopportune moments. It doesn't care if the last 5 minutes have been all cutscene or anything.
Autosave, come in with a cock block.
Now we're in a lovely hotel thing.
Games like this could use a map.
Happily, we don't have to gamble in this game.
Ugh.
For some reason, we got points for the looking in the mirror.
We hid these activities in this game. By God, you'll get points for them.
Gambling was the worst part of Legacy Larry 1.
Didn't it show up again in 5?
I don't know. I never played 5 all the way through.
Yeah. No, I'm pretty sure you had to do it in 5.
It's annoying. But you could save, scum. And you almost had to, really.
No. Oh, yeah. No, it's definitely 5. Because there was the casino.
This is copy protection, by the way.
Hmm.
We're supposed to have a magazine that came with the game box, but obviously we don't.
You know, if... You know, DRM was actually like a physical thing again, like you buy the game in the mail, you a fucking cool toy or something.
Or a code wheel.
Code wheel, yeah. Code wheel. Pirate wheel. Who's this pirate? Oh, it's Ship McGibbons. Yeah, well, it's your game.
Well, those little booklets that were unphotocopyable because it was black text on a black background. This is what the $20 was for, by the way. We're going to grease this dude's palm. We're going to pay man. Hmm.
This really does... I mean, I don't know. It's hard to gauge from when somebody else is playing it.
Hmm.
But it does feel like just wildly directionless.
Now let's play... Guess how long into the creation of this background the artist got bored with drawing audience members.
fuck it.
This is one of the take 5 moments in the game where you're in an unskippable cutscene where you can't skip past the text for some reason.
That's amazing.
So you can only watch the animations and go, oh look, allegedly sexy ladies.
People cared about this shit back then. It was...
Well, when you were a teenager and the hormones were raging and it was the 80s and the scrambled porn wasn't working, you could make the best of what you could with these tiny pixelated ladies.
Before internet porn, you had to have an imagination.
This is the introduction to our next target for seduction.
Cherry tart. They're not even trying. Betty cuntgasm.
Well, I'll say this. At least the girls have slightly more personality than they did in the Confessions of a Window Cleaner films.
I don't know, man. Tawny didn't have much of I like shopping! Well, get a credit card. Me well, shop. Touch penis.
Well, they had even less than that in Confessions of a Window Cleaner. Mm. They just want to have sex with the protagonist for no reason. Certainly not because he was attractive.
Is she, like, fighting something?
I don't know what she's doing. She seems to be spinning around on one foot, and people are throwing money at her.
Oh, it's money. I thought it was, like, cabbages. I thought she was, like, you cannot hit me with a cabbage.
Yes, this is how the farmer's market works on this island. You put on a bikini, spin around on one leg, and then people sell you cabbages.
She's making coleslaw.
She's making coleslaw with the thing on her back, which is actually like a chopping blade.
She's five blades in one. It's really impressive.
And now they're selling her on the shopping channel.
Good. I gotta... These wanderings back through old adventure games sure takes the goddamn shine off them sometimes.
Yeah, I made that conclusion when I was replaying this. I sort of remember it being better than it is.
Well, I mean, console games, you know, used the sprites and didn't have much in the way of, you know, plot a lot of the time. And, like, because, you know, PC games, they have the legs are moving and the characters are moving and it's not just a sprite going bip, 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 bip. So it always just seemed more impressive. Like, the graphics were just always a bigger deal.
Just wait outside this door like a creepy, creepy man.
So wait, you actually had to just walk around?
Or just wait.
Okay. How would you know to do that? Like,
you wouldn't.
So if you leave, does it? You have to just stand there for a set period?
I guess.
Huh. Okie dokie.
Something about the way the women are drawn in this game.
Collagen lips. What the hell are you?
Larry is very easy to open up to, apparently. Or this woman doesn't know when not to overshare.
What talented, popular woman doesn't want to just constantly talk to a fat dude in a leisure suit? That's...
Well, she wants land to like, have a farm on. And, as part of our divorce settlement, we have some land,
it's
apparently.
Threatened me.
So we're just gonna, just like with the credit card, we're just gonna hand it straight to the first chick we see in return for a hand job.
This is...
Or a fully clothed rubbing.
Yeah, and over the pants, kind of, like you're really aggressively petting a dog.
Bump and grind without the bump or the grind.
Just and
lie on top of.
That is some Mormon shit. That's the big book of Mormon erotica. Had to touch over the clothes.
After 6 months of marriage, you may unzip your flies.
No, you're not allowed to know what a vagina looks like. Enjoy that surprise. Better hope you're programmed to enjoy them, because otherwise, dear God.
Yes. Start studying pork pies and ham sandwiches.
Just punch yourself in the eye a couple of times and look at it.
This has that quality.
Never would have
of,
found that.
Yeah, that quality of forest exploration in certain adventure games where the paths aren't terribly clear.
Never would have wandered up there. Why would you?
Larry Laffer.
This is our pattern. We introduce ourselves to everyone. That's why we're so successful in love.
How to meet friends and influence people, so the first chapter.
I think this bloke might be a reference to someone who worked on the game.
Well, he has a face.
It's hard to tell.
When did this game come out? Like, how old is this?
Oh, blimey. No idea. 90-something.
I will look it up.
Hardly matters.
I am a bit curious.
This is another of our potential conquests.
Of course it is. It looks vaguely like a woman.
It's a lady lawyer. Well, you say that. Let's look at her face. She looks like Monica Lewinsky.
Gynoid 831.
She's got some crazy eyebrows going on. Actually, that's kind of the pattern for women in this game. Maybe that was
that was a period of human history where just
maybe it was the fashion of the time.
Yeah. We've had weird eyebrow fashions. There was a thing in Japan for a while of, like, shaving them half off and moving them up a few notches, and it is fucking terrifying looking. I don't know how dudes that coped.
Well, not just in Japan. It's a common thing, isn't it? To just draw them back in with eyebrow pencil?
No. Like, they'd move where the eyebrows were. So they'd be, like, 2 more inches up on the head and only about 1 inch long. And you can see it in some, like, old samurai movies and stuff like that, set in the era when that was popular. I can't remember the name for it. There was a name for it, but I've forgotten it.
They all start looking like Queen Amidala.
Yeah. Like, quite honestly, but in just a, like, you know how you start taking away the basic features of a face and it just switches that thing in your brain where it just doesn't look like a face anymore and it's scary?
Oh.
It was that.
Just shaving off the eyebrows certainly makes a face look weird.
I knew a goth kid that did that in high school and then it rained and he realized what eyebrows were for.
The eyebrows are the only part of the human face whose function is entirely to convey emotion and nothing else.
Whoa, no, that would be the 1989.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh. Well, I was wrong. I'd have said in the 90s.
Going back a ways.
But that explains a lot.
Mm. No, the actual fuzz of the eyebrow is to stop sweat and shit from getting in your eyes.
Well, yes, there is that as well, I suppose.
Dude, it is so vital. It was like this guy, it was just fucking great, because it's hot and sweat comes down. Sweat's got salt in it, so he's just, this shit was getting in his eyes. It was constantly fucking stinging.
My sweat does that anyway. Although one of my eyebrows is a bit wonky because there's a scar in it.
Huh. That's probably acting as like this conduit. Like just the water just doop, straight down to your eyeball
there's
now.
There's a little channel there. So we've got our land deed.
Here you go. Have land.
Yes.
That's expensive. Like, that's
one way to seduce women, I suppose. Here is some real estate.
I mean, like...
I mean, there's insisting on paying for dinner, and then there's this.
Yeah, I mean, I'd fuck someone for long-term real estate investments.
Yeah, I'd fuck you for long-term real estate.
Here you go, here's a good apartment and a high-rise. Alrighty.
I'd fuck you for the nice bit of real estate inside your rectum.
Prostate gardens. If you lived here, you'd be home by now.
Yeah, somehow there's something kind of weird about the tone in this game. Like, I wouldn't say it's kind of innocent, but it's certainly a lot more earnest than, say, Legends of Larry 1, which was, as I said, very openly cynical.
I mean,
this is all like, you know, giving women exactly what they want, and then they have sex with you.
It's kind of difficult, because I think a certain degree of the pacing from these games came from bumbling around and not knowing what you're doing. When you know what you were doing in these games, they're remarkably short. Like, it's a bip, 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 bip. And I think that kind of, you know, makes it just seem kind of weirdly mechanical as opposed to, you know, the 20 minutes you'd spend walking around going, I don't know what to do.
There's a weird choice of music for sex in this game. It sounds like a sort of waltz.
Isn't that common or something?
I don't know. It sounds like a sort of, you know, somewhere between a waltz and a marching song.
Best fuck music, God of War by Holst. Mars. 7 minutes long.
Again, there'd be some animation here if it was raunchy mode.
Well, you put your penis in the lady's belly button and then you sit still and then there's a baby.
So that's a joke that doesn't really make sense in this mode, because in raunchy mode it's a very, very overexerted sex animation. And this one, she's just lying on you again. It's the Mormon thing again.
I've never had a woman starfish on me. I would actually be sort of kind of curious now.
I've had a few women's starfish on me.
That's interesting. That's like, honestly?
Yeah, she took the glass out of the coffee table and didn't tell me. You see, what I'm doing there, listeners, is deliberately confusing the various euphemisms that starfish can mean.
Wordplay.
Right, now we've dressed up in the showgirl outfit and are on stage. Oh, lol, funny.
How did that even happen?
Sex comedy, because it's a sex comedy. Because you all got into a flap when the lights went off.
And accidentally put on 18 layers of showgirl outfit.
Accidentally put on a bikini and a feathery tail. And a headdress.
That's It is not possible to wear ladies' underpants if you have a penis and testicles that aren't, like, taped up or reinserted or something.
Well, maybe it's just hanging out the side. I mean, it's not like we can tell with this resolution, can we?
Let it dangle. Split it down the middle. It's like you have two ball sacks.
So what do you do when you're on a stage in a dancer's outfit?
Whip it out.
You dance.
Oh, okay. Now we get a great cutscene.
How do I get the feeling this is one of those games that is in the attitude of punishing you for wanting to have sex with women?
Well, that's what you get.
Fuck you. Fuck you, man, with your sex drive.
It wasn't just that. Like, that was just the attitude. Puritanical. You're not allowed to enjoy it. Nah, you can't tell the kids that it's fun. We have to tell them about STDs and shit.
Well, the fact that he's basically handed over all his worldly goods for sex at this point is kind of...
To be fair, though, that's... If you do that, you're an idiot.
Well, yes. It kind of makes you feel sad for the guy.
I know. Like, that's just depressing. Like,
he's obviously not... Well, he's the exact opposite of what Money Smart is at this point. But we've... Well, I say that, but we've just made half a grand. From dancing around. Nobody noticed that we were a fat dude.
I'd just see... I'd go back the next night. Alright, shows at like fucking 11, 2 and 6.
Maybe they were throwing money at you ironically. Going, haha, fat dude.
Isn't that how Patreon works?
Humiliating himself for our amusement.
Guessing you don't get to change anymore.
There's a bit of slowdown in this game when there's too much like animation on screen.
I love the authentic slowdown.
Yeah, I'm running this in DOSBox.
And you still get that in emulated.
Yeah,
like,
emulates the slowdown on top of everything else.
Just
to remind you what it's like.
There's a few things like some of the like the Nintendo 64 emulators, some of the PlayStation emulators can buff the graphics and fix a lot of stuff and just eliminate slowdown. Fuck, it's nifty.
But why would you want to? I mean, I kind of like those emulators where they also emulate what a TV screen would have looked like at the time.
Yeah, scan lines. A lot of stuff can do that.
Make the pixels a bit, you know, smudged with the background.
For the insane enthusiast.
It's like how people who like listening to old records like the scratching and humming sounding in the background. Because it adds to the nostalgia factor. But there's a reason we showed up here in our showgirl's outfit, by the way. This is conquest number 3. Although there's no way we would have known it would have been conquest number 3.
Just walk back in the feather outfit. She's got a bird fetish.
Actually...
Did I get that right?
Well, it is a fetish, but not a bird fetish.
Okay.
And we'll see what it is in a minute. It's a cross-dressing fetish.
Okay.
Because she's a powerful businesswoman. So obviously, she just wants to be a man.
She's going to drill you with a strap-on while screaming penis envy.
Social justice, social justice.
Well, this is justice.
This is
taking back from the patriarchy with a big strap-on. Unless he ejaculates, and then you're a slave.
This man wearing a showgirl's outfit degrades women.
I don't know, I think this is one of those games that just makes men look awful.
Now,
just Larry's just like, stop doing all the things you're doing.
Now, interestingly, this scene is almost completely unchanged in the various levels of sexy mode.
Huh. I know a lot of girls that do like putting makeup on, guys.
See, we're coming here in hope of a sex scene, but it starts to turn into a pun competition instead. I mean, who the fuck talks like this?
Is she meant to be buff or are those huge boobs?
I think... I'm not sure. Although she does have a gym membership, as we'll learn later. Okay, I think that's the last pun.
Thank God. I'm guessing they would have been moving here again. Whoa, look at that!
Yeah, as a teenager...
That suggests erections.
As a teenager, I of course hacked into this game and removed the hat.
I love you developing, like, because I had no idea how to fiddle with video games, but this is magic to me. So in my mind, here's you developing, like, these fucking Matrix-like abilities just to see a little bit of Larry's ass bobbing up and down.
Yeah, yeah. It wasn't worth it.
No, Jesus Christ.
They didn't put a whole lot of effort into the lady part.
One of your friend's uncles give him, like, a nude deck of cards or some shit, like...
Well, my dad gave me an old vintage issue of Playboy once.
There you go.
Although they had some crazy bushes back in those days. Not now, save, puff, save, auto thing. Imagine if I'd been trying to jerk off when that happened.
God fucking damn it.
Jesus Christ, this is worse than that nude scene in The Shining.
That scene where the dude's getting a blowjob from the dog costume.
There needs to be a prize for scene that best kills the efforts of people trying to masturbate midway through.
Okay. It was an episode of 6 Feet Under. Now, bear in mind, I haven't really watched all of 6 Feet Under.
I think I know exactly what you're going to say, because you said it on a previous video.
I don't either. That was a good one, though,
dude. When it cuts from the lesbian scene to the gay...
Gay dude's going, oh, fuck, yeah. And, again, it's like C. Michael Hall, back when he was a bit chubby, kind of, like, hunched over this other sweaty dude. And we're not talking, like, you know, Abercrombie and Fitch gay dudes. We're talking, like, standard gay dudes you'd see around. And they're kind of pudgy and shit. So it's just a bunch of jiggling man flesh right after, like, two really attractive girls about to play with each other in front of them, each other. And dear God, that was a shocker.
There's sort of reference here to maybe getting together again later.
Does that happen?
No.
Okay.
So, you know, don't know why we couldn't maybe try to pursue this relationship, but I guess this isn't a dating sim. These women are here to be used up and spat out. Or rather, you are here to be used up and spat out by the women.
You know. A little bit of mutual use is fine.
Well, quite. As long as we're all aware of what's going on.
And at least give me 5 minutes to have a coffee in the morning. Don't just bundle me under the house. Cause that's
and
just
as long
rude.
As the lady's credit card clears.
40 years and over, I'll need proof and... two credit card numbers.
Yeah, that is riding right up his crack, isn't it?
Yeah, that can't be fun.
That's disappearing into his rolls, I think.
Smuggled up in there, good. Folds coming down over it.
And of course, since we're in a different costume, we won't be able to do any of the other puzzles in this game until we've got our leisure suit back on.
So that would have been just a big pile of wandering around, bumping into shit, hoping to find out what's going on, and then just, oh, that's the woman likes... cross-dressing.
Yeah.
Which she didn't bring up or hint to or anything in any of the other conversations we had with her.
It is possible to put your suit on before you go to the lawyer and it'll just be an entirely business-like transaction and you won't get the points for it.
Huh.
Because that's what points mean. Points mean sex. And sex means points.
For a while when you're young, I suppose. You're still counting your goes.
I suppose. His letter to Larry is sort of over the whole monogamy thing, isn't he? Now he's just out to score points.
Touch the penis.
So I have to go back to the lawyers to pick up the papers. This is the second time I've had to do this. Basically, all you have to do is leave and then come back in. And then they'll because before they say, oh, we're still preparing your paperwork. Why don't you go away for a few minutes and come back?
Yeah, because time doesn't pass in these. You just have to trigger the event.
Walk out. Don't even let the door close behind you. Walk back in. Oh, hello again. Your papers are all ready.
The scene's reset. I'm a different person with different things to say.
Right, now I've got a membership card for a gym.
Because they're not going to realize your name's not Susie.
Well, they don't check. It's just a swipey card.
Do you actually meet Passionate Patty in this one?
Yeah. I mean, you do a hell of a lot more than just meet her.
Meet.
Well, yes. Doop de doop de do. Oh, wrong way. I accidentally went into the room where you can do nothing. And where nothing happens.
Really?
Yeah.
That looked like something from the set of The Prisoner.
I think that sums up a lot of this game. Here is a whale that is a gym.
Okay.
Do not question it.
Get in here, fatties.
Yes, again, there's zero direction as what to do at this point. We're just gonna...
Oh, Jesus.
Our unsaid goal at this point now is to exercise. We're going to get some exercise, and this will make us not fat.
Okie dokie.
Which is a good message for the kiddies. But again, it's not quite as cynical as you might expect from Legends of Larry. More copy protection, by the way. We need to look at the manual, find the three names of these businesses, find the numbers associated with them, and that's the... number of the locker? The combination for the locker.
God.
By the way, this game is split into two videos. And at the end of this video, I'm going to completely screw myself over. It's just sort of a coincidence that it happened at pretty much the exact halfway point of the game.
Well, it was a happy... You did it on purpose, then.
See if you can guess how it will happen. It does happen in the gym. I haven't screwed up yet.
Okay. Is it to do with a costume change?
Tangentially.
Okay, well, I mean, you have to paint yourself into a corner, so...
Yes.
Look, 69 over there. Great.
Yes, we're looking for locker 69, because 69 is a hilarious, sexy number. I'm just enter the combination and open the locker, because we can't exercise in our leisure suit. That's bad. Obviously. I mean, you like your exercise, don't you?
Yes, I do. And I have to do, like, 2 loads of laundry a day as a result. Scantily clad Tom Selleck.
So I put on some women's sweats, that's the joke.
They're quite comfortable.
I'm not even going to probe to know how you know that.
Girl's yoga pants, man.
That's the shower, I didn't know. No. Exercise is in here.
Look at it, it's a black hole on the left. Shower. Okay.
Now, the exercise machine was a cause of much grief for me when I first had this game back in the 90s. Because for some ridiculous reason, the number of reps you have to do on each machine is based on your processor speed.
That's fucking amazing.
I don't know why that should that had to be the case.
So it's reading your processor speed and going, okay, you're spectacular, you know, computer now, you have to do it forever.
So because this is an emulated DOS machine, it's only 21. But when I first played this game, it was on a Pentium 100 running Windows 95, I think. And I think I ended up having to do 470 for each one.
Oh, that's fucking great. It's like when I tried to play,
No, it was not fucking great. It was very awful.
Police Quest 3, and it has these little driving sequences that are arcadey, and they're just set to the fucking clock speed of the computer.
Yeah, a similar thing happens in Space Quest 4. There's a couple of things you can't get past because the enemy just hits you instantly. Yes, it does tell you when you've done enough, mercifully.
400.
Oh, by the way, we're walking dead. We're walking dead right now as we do this.
See, that doesn't look a thing like fucking Larry.
No, I mean, like he seems to have lost a bit of weight as well.
Well, that and the kind of comical, you know, shapeliness of his face, I think.
No, he just looks like a dude.
Yeah. Looks like John Glames.
Well, he was a very generic-looking man, John Glames.
Yeah, I think that hurts it. Like, part of the fun's, you know... What's that? That's Larry. That's his, you know, big stupid nose and his caveman brow and his stubby little chin. And
then it's funny when shitty things happen to him. We go, ha-ha, let's look at this little jester man as he capers for our amusement.
Look at the troll try to be people.
No,
so you're Walking Dead now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Have you guessed why?
You didn't get a towel to shower, or...?
Nope.
You've worked out too hard.
No, I haven't worked out enough yet.
Is it... Okay, so it's not anything to do with that clock speed thing.
No.
Okay.
We were walking dead from the instant we entered this room.
Ah. You didn't bring a towel?
No, you already guessed that.
No, did I? I don't know then. Alright, tell me.
We'll find out at the end of this video.
Walking dead the moment you entered the room, not before you used the thing?
No.
Those aren't pull-ups.
Well, when I say the moment I entered this room, perhaps I mean the moment I left the previous room.
Oh, okay. Ah, you didn't shut the fucking locker.
Bingo!
And they stole all your shit. What the fuck?
Though we won't know this yet.
That's exactly how exercise works. It's amazing.
I remember this animation felt like a huge reward when I'd done 470 of each of that bloody things.
Oh, power up!
I think it actually makes sense now. We'd basically turn into One Punch Man at that point.
I'm unstoppable!
I think this is the point in the game where things sort of... the tone sort of changes. Where suddenly everything starts going Larry's way.
Well, yeah, now you've got muscles.
Yeah,
how the world works.
Now you fit within acceptable boundaries of attractiveness. Yeah. You may now join society.
You have reached the male ideal.
Lol.
Remember we're in,
Although we do still have massive muscles, they're just, you know, practical now.
Yeah. Remember in Red Dwarf? At the end of, Nanaki, where they gave, like, list of the better body? And he was meant to have a really muscular body, but then didn't really, like... You know, Craig Charles didn't do the exercise, so they just dropped it completely like a stone for the next series.
Yeah. Yes, so at this point I didn't realise what had happened. Pre-recorded video, of course. I just put on my towel. Oh! And now we cannot leave this room because we can't get our suit back. Yes. Well, that's the end of the first video of Legacy Larry 3. You people listening will probably have to wait another week, or less, depending on how I feel, to see the rest of it. We're just going to go straight on to the next video.
You know what we should do? We should, like, never release the second half, and that can be our, like, Leisure Suit Larry 4.
Or we'll just release it to our Patreon subscribers that we don't have.
Patreon makes me feel better about being a welfare bum.
Anyway, tune in next time to see the thrilling conclusion of Leisure Suit Larry 3, : Passionate Patty in the Pursuit of the Pulsating Pectorals. Next time, the subtitle becomes relevant.
Yeah, we haven't seen Passionate Patty yet.
Yes. We'll see her next time. That was the hint.
Titties.
And cocks. Just go away!